Hello, Slicey Dicers. This is Brian with another rapid fire review session for you. Pew pew. I'm sorry. You guys love it when I do the pew pews. I feel very silly to my soul when I do it, but gonna keep doing it until you guys tell me to stop. Someone please tell me to stop. We have two Finches and two Ashers for you. So how this works is, instead of doing the full lengthy reviews on these, we're just gonna do shorter reviews, cramming it together in one video. I think it works really well, especially for companies like Finch and Asher that are kind of new, and it gets it more views, because if you're interested in one of these four, maybe you'll watch the whole video and you'll be interested in one of the others. So that's part of the reason why I do this. So how it's going to go is our usual kind of review format, but in a compressed format. I'm going to go left to right, and then we're going to wrap it up. So here we go. We are going to start off with the Finch 1929. Now, the 1929 is obviously by design. It's supposed to be kind of traditional looking. It definitely has a lot of very modern flares running on bearings. 154 cm steel, which I do like to see a lot. It's one of my favorite steels, especially at this price, which is $120. I don't think that's too bad at all. CPM 154, 154 cm, potato, potato. I know one's powdered, one's not, but it's really hard to tell the difference. But anyway, it's a great steel. It takes a really good screaming edge very easily, and for average EDC stuff, it's going to hold it completely fine. This is kind of a bolster lock design, stainless steel frame. This one is the dark denim micarta, which I was kind of expecting to be sort of blue, but it's definitely like a black micarta, which is dark denim. That kind of makes sense. It does come in lots of different colors. Also comes in a cocobolo wood. It comes in a carbon fiber. It comes in a jade, and it comes in a crawdad jig bone. Which I think crawdad jig bone, you must say in a southern accent. I don't think you can say that in a northern accent, so I apologize to southerners, but crawdad jig bone should not be said. Crawdad jig bone. I sound completely stupid. I even did a little southern on the bone. Crawdad jig bone. It sounds dumb. Crawdad jig bone. That's how you're supposed to say this. But $120, not too bad at all. This is a fairly small knife. You're looking at a blade length of 2.5 inches, overall length of 6 inches, a blade thickness of 0.1116 inches, handle thickness thinner than it feels, 0.47 inches, and a weight of 3.1 ounces. Again, I really like the look of this. It's kind of that Barlow-y sort of slightly clip pointy blade. I do like that a lot. I'm not really good with traditional blade shapes, so I'm sure somebody's going to correct me down below and say, actually, it's a whatever. This is one time I won't roll my eyes at you, because, yeah, tell me. I think it's a Barlow, but it is a bit different than a Barlow. Tell me what this traditional blade shape is called. Ergos are pretty good for a knife this size. I will say that for my, I have large size hands, pretty skinny fingers. This is like a 3.25 finger knife. It's, if you have fingers remotely larger than mine, it's definitely going to be a 3-finger knife. But ergos are really good. Can't feel the pocket clip much. It is a nice titanium milled pocket clip, which is pretty cool for $120. And it carries pretty well. Again, it just feels like, when I took it out of the box, my impressions of this are, if I can do a summary statement, I thought it was going to be kind of heavy, because it just feels heavy and kind of overbuilt. But it isn't heavy. I like that about it a lot. So if you're looking for something with kind of a traditional sort of look, this isn't going to freak anybody out in the office, except for maybe that snap. But it's got a lot of modern features that us knife people would like. It is also, by the way, 14.5 thousandths behind the edge. So it slices extremely well. Extremely well. That thin blade stock and that really thin behind the edge. Man, it's a slicing machine. It's going to work for anything that you want. It's not really going to upset anybody, especially maybe in the wood or the crawdad jig bone. It'll intimidate even fewer people. I don't know what it is about wood or traditional materials don't bother people as much. But yeah, I think it's a really cool, like, office carry. It's a bit different if you just don't want to have a slip joint, but you kind of want that look. I really like it. I think it's very unique. I like the name of it, 1929. I'm sure it's inspired by some particular year. Something that happened in that year was a Great Depression. You name a knife after that. I'm sure it probably says in their literature, and I did not see it. So I apologize, Finch. I do like your knife very much. I just didn't research why it's called the 1929. Next up, another Finch. This is the Cimarron. This one is less expensive. You're looking at 14C28N steel. Also, another one of my favorite EDC steels. 14C28N, you see it on, like, the Kershaw Bare Knuckle, some of the rakes, some other knives. You see it on, it's a great steal for kind of a budgety knife. This is a bit more than what I would consider super budgety. $89 for this one. That's a bit much. Again, you are running on bearings, but much for the steel, but not for everything else. But still, I love 14C28, so it doesn't bother me. I just know that some people are going to be like, I can get a whatever for $89 with whatever steel. Yeah, you're probably right. There's another one here that you can get for less than that with better steel, but still, it's a good steel. It does come in many, many colors. Again, with the titanium milled pocket clip. And you have, this one is the green and... Yeah, the green and tan G10, sorry. You can get also in a blue and green G10. You can get it in a blue and a light green. And you can get it in a blue-gray G10 and a gray and yellow G10. So you can get it in several different colors. I would prefer not this, but I just don't like green. This is kind of a dark, it's even darker than British Racing Green, like a forest green, I guess you'd call it. It does complement well with the tan. It's just not my particular taste. This is not a negative, just saying that that color combo is not my particular taste. Specs-wise, you were looking at a blade length of... Make sure I have this whole thing on the camera while I'm doing this. You have a blade length of 3.4 inches, overall length of 7.8 inches, blade thickness of 0.12 inches, handle thickness of 0.43 inches and a weight of 3 ounces. And I do have to say, both of these Finches get the golf clap because they're exactly the weight that they claim, both of them. They claim this one to be 3.1, this one to be 3. That's what they weigh, dead on. So always get the golf clap if you get your weights dead on in your claims. Much like the 1929, one thing I do like about it looks-wise is I like this little shield on here. It looks like a car emblem. I think it's pretty cool. I saw like another reviewer say it. He thought it made him look cheap. I think it makes it look awesome. I completely disagree with that, but I do like that about the looks. One thing I don't like about the looks on this, and honestly, it's probably my biggest complaint about the knife, is aesthetically, it's just, I don't mind, I'm not a big blade to handle ratio guy who really gets upset about it as far as, you know, this way, but in the horizontal as we're looking at it, but in the vertical, it does really bother me just aesthetically. I don't think it matters a whole ton with the way the knife is used, but just I don't like when the blade is this much thinner than the handle. Everybody's gonna say, but Brian, you love the 940. Yeah, the Benchmade 940 gets away with it, but and a couple other knives get away with it. I don't think this one gets away with it. I aesthetically, I just don't like the way that looks. But ergonomically, it's great. Action-wise, it's superb. Again, running on bearings. It's a great knife, for sure. It's just, I don't like the look of that. I do like the steel choice. I don't mind the price on the 1929 at all. On this one, I think they're really pushing their luck, $89 with this one. The scales look very expensive, and they probably are, and I think that's where all the money is going. Next up, we're going to move on to the Ashers. First up, we have the Asher Spyro, or Spiro. I'm going to say Spyro. We're just going to declare it's called Spyro. But I don't know. It's probably Spiro. Who knows? S35VN. G10 liner lock, again running on bearings. $75 for this one. Not too bad at all. I'm gonna get one thing out of the way off the bat with Asher. So they're a new company. They're working with a new OEM. There's been some teething issues, but they have been superb with taking care of them. And a recent one that they had, they've only had two. One of their first releases was supposed to be on bearings that showed up on washers. They gave people a discount, and then, for me anyway, I had gotten one that was supposed to be on bearings and showed up on washers. They sent me a free knife later on when the one with bearings came out. So, he seems to be a great dude. He's one-man shop. Seems to be a great dude taking care of people. But another issue they had, it was not with this knife, but it was tested by Love Them Knives, those steel test things, and it says S35N, and it came out as 440C. Well, he's been reblading all the knives that came with the wrong steel. And sure, that's not going to happen again. It was not this. This has come out since then. Seems like S35VN to me. I'm going to take their word that it is because they're very good about fixing stuff. And if you're good about fixing stuff, you're going to want to get it right and not have to keep constantly fixing stuff. So I'm going to assume that it's okay. So we're just going to put that aside for the rest of this, but I know somebody's going to say it in the comments, so I wanted to get that out of the way. On this, specs-wise, you have a blade length of 3.2 inches, overall length of 7.4 inches. Blade thickness, very thin, 0.09 inches. Handle thickness, 0.46 inches. And a weight of 3.2 ounces. This one only comes in this black with the jade backspacer, which is cool because you can dye it whatever the hell you want to. Some people seem to be just assumed it was glow in the dark, but it's not. It's just jade, and they don't claim that it's glow in the dark, so I'm not sure why some people thought that. But ergonomically, excellent. Probably the most comfortable in the hand of any of them here. Pocket clip, if for my hands, disappears. It fits in the crotch of my palm, as you guys like me to say. It fits very well in there, and it's just, it's ergonomically excellent. Superb slicer. You're looking at, again, about the same as the 1929, 15 thousandths behind the edge, and even thinner blade stock. Both pretty equal as far as the sharpening department goes. And man, this thing will cut. It is a slicer for sure. If I have one complaint about it, and it's going to be kind of weird because I prefer bearings because I don't work in like a dirty environment. But my thought with this was with the liner lock and the thumb studs and that really good, just kind of simple blade shape and overall sort of simple shape. Kind of wish it was on bronze washers instead of the bearings, because it would just be easier to, it wouldn't get as gummed up and all that stuff. And I don't know, I just think it'd be a bit more of a workhorse if it was on the washers. The action wouldn't be as good, but I don't know, I think if I was specking it out, I probably would have put it on washers. That's just me. But other than that, awesome knife. $75. I'm sure the steel is correct now. Yeah, awesome slicer. Definitely do recommend this one for $75. And lastly, we have the Asher Flashback. Again, kind of like the 1929, meant to, it's kind of inspired by these more traditional designs. It's meant to kind of remind you of those. Only comes in this gray G10. We've got 12C27 end steel on here. So again, a fairly unique steel choice. All three out of four of these knives have a fairly unique steel choice that you don't see as often as you used to. And I like all three of these steels, so no problem. 12C27N, not as good as 14C28, as you can tell by the lower digits, but still takes a screaming edge. It's going to hold it plenty well for most people's daily use. And this knife is undoubtedly inexpensive at $39.50. Again, on bearings, awesome action. Just awesome action on this thing. Very snappy. I do like that it has a little traditionally looking nail nick. I would like this just as much if it just didn't even have the flipper tab. It's nice because it's a nice snappy little flipper, but I think it would be just as compelling as a two-hand open knife, especially for, you know, different places, you know, for Europe or whatever. Carries really well. Specs wise, you're looking at a blade of 3 inches, overall length of 7.1 inches, blade thickness 0.11 inches, handle thickness of 0.46 inches, and a weight of 2.4 ounces. About 22 thousandths behind the edge, a little thicker than the others, but still pretty thin blade stock, still a pretty good slicer. That same great pocket clip that you have on the Spyro. You know, I haven't talked a lot about how these knives carry because it's the rapid fire review and I don't bring out, you know, Yale Levi's for that. All of them carry pretty darn well. So don't worry about that. They're all definitely good pocket carries. So $39.50, if you want something a bit different than your average Civivi or whatever, I know people are going to say, oh, you can get D2. Sometimes I would rather have something like this than D2 because even though it's not as good at edge retention, just it's stainless, it's easier to sharpen. And so yeah, so this would be the end of the video, except that I'm including a very super secret giveaway. Super secret giveaway. So the guy from Asher told me that I named this knife the Flashback, that I told him, I suggested the name for it. I have no remembrance of that. But I forget things. So down below in the comments, comment Brian forgets things and spell my name correctly, and you can win this knife. I'm gonna wait until the live show on Sunday which right today it is the February 17th. So this coming Sunday, I will do on the live show. I'll pick somebody out of the people. I'll generate a little random list thing. Just comment down below. Brian forgets things. People who didn't watch the video at the end will have no idea what's going on. But yeah, comment Brian forgets things for a chance to win this knife. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this. I like these rapid fire review things. You guys seem to as well. I've been Brian. Have a good one.